For USCFootball.com, I'm Keely Eure here with Dan Weber. Instant analysis of the Wednesday practice leading up to the Utah game. It was an interesting thing that both you and I noticed. At the end of practice, in the final team period, USC went ones versus ones, and we're used to seeing them go one versus twos and vice versa. And it was interesting. We noted it, and then Helton actually noted it in his presser, and they specifically wanted to do that to mimic Utah's edge rusher so that USC's O-line can be used to that.
Yeah, because we've been sort of advocating that kind of thing. And I talked to, Cameron Smith and Chris Hawkins and everybody we talked to said they really liked, and we're only allowed to talk to the defense today, but they really liked the idea of, and then Clay will tell you, yeah, goods against goods, iron sharpens iron and all of that. And I think it's true. Yeah. And, you don't want to harken back to, the Pete Carroll era, but that was one of the really good things in terms of the competitiveness of their practices, because they didn't go that long, but they always had a period where they had the ones against the ones, and they took great pride in that. And I thought it worked well today. I thought Sam looked really good in that situation, and the defense liked the idea of, they're getting challenged with Sam. And Clay liked the idea of for the offensive tackles to see what it's like to be dealing with, say, Chenna on the pass rush on the edge. So I think it's just really a good move by everybody involved, and we're glad to see it.
Mm-hmm. But it does beg the question. I mean, USC is as injured as they are right now, and they're starting to do this first team versus first team. Why not do it earlier? Why not? If you can mimic Utah's edge rush now, you could possibly mimic other things in past games. So why do you think right now is the time to do it?
Because it's right now. I mean, you asked the question, why not? Why not? Indeed, why not? I don't know that there's a really good answer for that. Why not? So, they got there. And I think they realized that the next 2 weeks are really important. I mean, if they get through these next 2 weeks, you really got a fighting shot to finish this season out the way you want and end up in a very good place. But these next 2 weeks really, really matter. And so I think having your team, I think Cam said that they did get a little bit of a breather. By playing on Friday night, at least they get that long weekend. You've got the Oregon State game last week. So they're kind of recharged a little bit. When we saw guys coming back today, Jordan Iosefa, Jalen Green probably didn't expect Chuma Adoga to be back, and I don't think Clay did. And basically, Chuma was in there pretty much all the way with the first-team offense at right tackle. So, and Daniel Motter-Baby pretty much went through practice, not a normal tight end, starting tight end. But now you can legitimately ask the question, what about this week? Everybody's thinking coming back for Notre Dame. Now it's like, what do you think? So, in some ways, I think they're as injured as they have been. I think they're on kind of an upswing at this point and are like, we're getting there. I think Sam, for example, and we won't throw him in there with that particular category. We just don't really know what's going on. But he looks smoother. He looks like he's running and throwing easier. He just looks like he's in a different place. And it's obvious, I think, this week. So, from a lot of those standpoints, this is probably, a good couple of days.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you actually stole my next point. I was going to mention how it was almost a 180 for Chuma Adoga. Yesterday, he didn't even practice, wasn't dressed. Today, he comes out fully dressed like the rest of the players, a taped left ankle, and plays, except for the last team period, looked pretty much healthy. Like you said, Helton was pretty surprised at how well he did. What's your percentage of if we see Chuma out there?
I don't think he would have come back today. Yeah. Without the idea that I'm going to play Saturday. Now, sometimes you come back today and you push it hard, you push it all the way or almost all the way, and then you realize, okay, I'm not quite back yet. So I don't think we know. I mean, the key part of that is not so much what happens in practice, but what happens in the next 24 hours as to how his ankle reacts to it. But I thought he pushed hard. I thought that's kind of an inspiration, I think, to his teammates, because, you can tell, you look at his left ankle and you realize, man, that's a lot of tape on there.
Yeah.
He didn't back off a bit. And I think they look at Chuma, and when they see Chuma doing that, I think that's a real positive for this team.
Mm-hmm. Also, just to mention quickly, Deontay Burnett did not practice today, but they said it was just for rest, his sore shoulder and toe, but we should see him on Saturday. You got to talk to special teams today. They are kind of playing musical chairs, if you will, thanks to Damon Johnson, who got hurt on Saturday.
Well, the plan was to talk to special teams.
Oh.
They didn't exactly come back. They leave early, and they do their weightlifting and do other, you know, work together, but they don't have to, you know, work on this field after they do all the team stuff. So we didn't exactly get them back.
Okay.
But one of the things that we did see them work on is you've got with Reed Budrich becoming the new holder, because Wyatt Schmidt, the old holder, is now the new long snapper. On two of the special teams now, you have Wyatt Schmidt snapping the ball to Reed Budrich. And he, you know, it allows Reed to still be, either he catches the ball as a punter, or he's now catching the ball as the holder. So you're building up some chemistry there, because when they do the punting, he's getting snaps from Wyatt. When they do the place kicking, he's getting snaps from Wyatt. So they're keeping some consistency there. And it's good to, when they practice here, one of them has a Cardinal number 46 on, the other has a white number 46 on. Obviously, that will change for Saturday. But just one of those little, you know, interesting little quirks that just happens, that you got two number 46, and the way it's broken out, you've got them snapping, one snapping, the other catching on a couple of different special teams that are going to be different this week. And that's a challenge, because they're playing the team that year in, year out, by far has the best special teams in the Pac-12. Just the best punter in the country. A field goal kicker walked out, you know, from some soccer team somewhere, and now he's, you know, 15 out of 16 for the year. So you've got to do special teams well. And Clay just said, thinks their punt return game is the best in the country. So, and USC's is not. Exactly. Well, you can't say anything bad about USC's punt return game, because we haven't actually seen it yet. I mean, you have to actually see a punt return before you could criticize one. But so you better be ready for Utah's.
Yeah, I was about to ask you about that. This is a tough Utah team where you have to get everything right. We haven't necessarily seen that from USC through all three phases, getting everything done. From what you've seen in practice this week, what's the feel for Saturday? What do you think is going to happen?
I think this is a week where USC's fairly tough schedule comes to play. I mean, I think if they've got an advantage over Utah, it's the game's not in Salt Lake City to begin with. And Utah opened the season playing North Dakota, playing San Jose State, who's just really just awful. You know, played people that just weren't in the same place. And the first time they played somebody who was really good, Stanford, they couldn't quite handle them. So from that standpoint, you think the thing that USC falls back on, being at home, and you know, this is the game they have to win.
Yeah.
And they've been tested more. I mean, they haven't necessarily aced all their tests, but they've been tested more than Utah. I know everybody says, well, you don't know who's going to be quarterback for Utah. It might be three different guys. And all you can say about that is, if it's the really good, you know, Tyler Huntley, who's missed the last couple of games, he hasn't played then for a couple of weeks. Or if it's, you know, somebody else, you think, well, he played his greatest game ever against USC last year. Can he do that again? I don't know. So I think the advantage is to USC. I think the home field advantage is really big in this game.
Mm-hmm. All right, that's going to wrap it up from Howard Jones Field. For Dan Weber, I'm Keely Eure. For more, check out USCfootball.com.